Hi everybody, Shane Lee here with Taps again. Welcome back to another audio video. This one I've been patiently trying to work on. It's a lot of work, but I am putting out the best of most interesting audio from the last 2 years. A lot of this has not been heard. A lot of this has not been put on YouTube. Some of it has. It's in some of the previous clips of investigations. And a couple of things to keep in mind here. First, there's a lot of clips. So, no, I did not try to remove all the background noise and all the recorder fuzz. I just tried to remove as much as I could, still keep it natural, but you can still hear the audio. The second thing is, we don't claim that everything here that you're about to listen to is a Sasquatch. Sometimes there's no way of knowing. A lot of it we do plan on getting analyzed. But most of this is just blatantly obvious. So if you have any logistical common sense about you, you'll be able to figure it out pretty quickly by listening to it. Thirdly, anybody that believes that Sasquatch only makes one vocal or one noise, you might as well just shut this off and move on. Go somewhere else because you're going to be way too close-minded to listen to this video. Thirdly, a lot of work went into it. Had some three other members of TAPS contribute their audio as well. And it's all really good stuff. So just taking the time to actually listen to this, we really appreciate it. And the best thing to do is put on a really good set of headphones. If you can use your phone speaker, the computer speaker as well too, because you'll hear it just fine. This isn't something you have to hold your hand over your ears and try to listen real hard. You're still gonna hear it just fine. But the best two ways to listen to it is a good set of headphones or a Bluetooth speaker. A nice Bluetooth speaker, you can get all the sounds. It's really good. Now, back to the audio or the vocalizations that Sasquatch make. As I was saying, there's more than one. You know, you people that have been out there and heard these things personally, you know there's more than one. And with them being so closely related to us, as I believe, and a lot of others believe as well, they have moods, you know, whether it be exciting, aggressive, you know, having a bad day. There's people that have encounters with Sasquatch that aren't so happy. And so they'll know exactly what I'm talking about there. But I think a lot of their audio, or should I say a lot of their mentality on that day, their behavior can be displayed through their audio vocals. And you'll kind of see what I'm saying by excited, not excited, bad day, whatever the case may be. You'll see what I'm talking about when you're listening to these. And also, you can kind of tell when it's a younger Sasquatch trying to vocalize, or maybe even a female. It's a different tone to it. And those that have heard the full-grown adult male make his single holler at night, it's unmistakably. It's deep, it's loud, and it's got some bass to it. But as you listen, you'll be able to hear what sounds like younger ones, you know, trying to learn. You know, they're learning. They're doing their vocalizations, too. Just because you're a young Sasquatch don't mean you don't talk or anything. You don't make any noises. Yeah. As, you know, as you listen to it, just pay attention. There's going to be a lot of coyotes. I removed a lot of the coyote because there was so much in some of the segments. It just became annoying listening to the yip, especially when you're trying to amplify the background noise. Yep, the Sasquatch. So there's a big correlation between the Sasquatch and the coyotes, especially here in the South. I can't say as much as the North because I haven't done much investigating up there. But down here, there always seems to be them with the Sasquatch. It's either the Sasquatch and the coyotes or the coyotes and the Sasquatch or right in the mix or after. You know, there's a whole conglomeration of incidents there to where they're with the coyotes. And the second thing is, there was a lot of dead space in these, and I didn't want this video to be, you know, 2 hours long. So anytime there was just seconds upon seconds of dead space in any of these audios, I pulled those out just to shorten the clips a little bit. And that way you're not sitting here listening to this for over an hour, although I don't think you'd mind, which is pretty impressive. Also, for all those that were involved, I'd like to say thank you. You'll see their name on the bottom of the audio file when it goes by. It'll say property and courtesy of. Also, if there's any files that you would like to see singled out and independently analyzed, or independently had a video made of it. Look in the top left side of the screen, you'll see a little pair of headphone icon up there in the left top, and right next to it, the title. Write that title down, hit us up on Facebook and send me a message with that, and let me know you'd like to see a video of just that, and I'll do it. Without further ado, we're going to get this ball rolling. And of course, once again, if you don't mind, please like, subscribe, and hit that notifications bell. Also, join us on Facebook by typing in Texas Acknowledgement, Awareness, and Preservation of Sasquatch. And it'd be a lot easier if you just hit the Facebook icon on the YouTube channel. It'll take you directly to us. That way you can message me or any of the other admins or any information, questions, concerns, anything else, and see all the great evidence that the TAPS members have put out under the post topics. It's really good stuff. So I appreciate it. Just share our videos and we'll go from there and we'll just keep posting this stuff. Thank you.
front side of their pitch. Thank you. Sasquatches.
Thank you.